All right, we'll be talking about several issues when it comes to education. We have with us Senator Risa Ontiveros, who is calling for a probe on the matter and also the release of the 7 billion pesos for the beneficiaries of CHED. Senator Ontiveros, good morning to you, ma'am. Ma'am, you're on mute.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good morning, Karen, and to all our viewers.
All right. Senator, you are filing a resolution about these allegedly overpriced laptops that were bought by the PSDBM. Let's talk about exactly ang resolution na ito. Sino po ang gusto niyong papanagutin?
Sinusulat pa namin yung resolution, Karen, but I'd like to broaden the view of the Blue Ribbon Committee or whichever committee my resolution will be referred to go beyond just the laptop issue to PSDBM's role in all such transactions. Kasi ang PSDBM, hindi siya mas mataas, hindi siya above procurement laws. It is COA also that has flagged this and other transactions. So we're only reiterating COA's findings. Perhaps the DepEd and other agencies that have been flagged in their procurement transactions by COA should take a closer look at those COA reports. Tingin ko kasi, Karen, kailangan natin mas tignan ng malapit kung ano ang pinagagagawa ng PSDBM, lalo na ngayong mga taon ng pandemya. So I will file a resolution soon. Sa katunayan, Karen, wala pang ang closure yung issue ng formally. At dahil nga sangkot di umano sa aming mga findings, no, sa draft committee report noon, sangkot talaga ang PSDBM doon. Dapat maisalang sila ulit sa hearing kung paano naman nila ginagamit pa rin ang pera ng taong bayan. This time, pagdating sa iba pang mga ahensya ng gobyerno, kung sa formally DOH ang di umano kasabwat nila noon, ngayon naman may kasabwat ba sila sa DepEd at sa iba pang mga ahensya. Mukhang maraming mga ahensya pa ang nadamay sa mga practices ng PSDBM. In fact, the characters from formally seem to be reprising their kontrabida roles in more recent anomalies flagged by the Commission on Audit. So at this point, siguro lahat ng mga procurement na pinangasiwaan ng PSDBM should be looked into, questionable at mga kahinahinalang mga transaksyon. After all, it is within the purview of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee. And we do look forward to the committee calling these officials of PSDBM back so that these numerous issues are investigated.
Oh, good point, Secretary. Now, in the past, I've interviewed, for example, former Health Secretary Francisco Duque. He talked about the role of PSDBM where he claims, and I'm sure other secretaries would claim this, that if you let procurement pass through PSDBM, they claim it is faster. So that's one. But then they also, the problem is they claim PSDBM is in charge of even the bidding process. So I wanted to ask you this. The Commission on Audit, its 2021 annual audit report, so I have it with me here, shows that the supplier of these laptops, joint venture Sunwest Construction and Development Corporation, LDLA Marketing and Trading Inc., and VST ECS Philippines, I'm reading from the actual report, the COA claims that PSDBM favored this particular company, all right, over three other bidders, despite the failure of Sunwest Construction to meet the technical specifications for the project. So, ang tanong dito is, Senator, have you found out who is Sunwest? Why would they be favored based on the COA report?
We're still just, as I mentioned, writing the resolution, Karen, and lampas pa dito sa specific issue ng di umanong overpriced laptops. We really want the resolution to look at more, or if not possibly all, more other transactions, procurements that PSDBM has conducted ostensibly on behalf of government agencies. So yung mga particularities nitong tungkol sa laptops ay siguradong tatanungin din namin at aalamin. And if COA itself has already pointed out a particular problem of favoring of some bidders over others whom COA may be thinking were more qualified, then we will also get to the bottom of that. And I think sa pag-imbestiga nitong lahat ng mga issue, we will really naturally circle back to PSDBM. And makikwestiyon namin, talaga bang mas mabilis? At kung mas mabilis, tapat pa rin ba sa requirements under the procurement law para hindi mukhang nagpapatuloy o umuulit yung maling kagagawa ng PSDBM at ng mga kasabwat nilang departamento as we saw in the Farmaly investigation.
Okay, because just moving on from this, I know you're still going to iron out the specifics. The COA report saying that that the PSDBM favored a specific company. What's interesting with this Sunwest Corporation is Congressman Zaldico was one of the owners of, or he had a stake in Sunwest Corporation, and he came out with a statement claiming that he divested from Sunwest Corporation. But then you have other bidders asking, if he isn't behind Sunwest Corporation, why would Sunwest Corporation get this particular contract? So my question is, given that he is also a congressman and you have parliamentary respect, so to speak, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Will he be included in the investigation?
Well, since he already came out with that statement nag-divest na nga siya, since starting the company or before those questionable transactions came up, maaring itanong pa rin, at least for the record. Bukas naman sa kahit sinong mambabatas, observing parliamentary immunity, to ask policy questions tungkol sa katapatan or paglabag ng mga ahensya tulad ng PSDBM, katapatan dun sa procurement law, regardless of who is or was on the other side of the table. So fair question naman yon, at confident ako sa Blue Ribbon Committee at sa mga kapumambabatas tulad ng mga representante to answer truthfully.
Oo. Would you consider the laptops overpriced? Because this has also been a debate. Some have said the price of the laptop with its technical specifications actually don't make it overpriced. But some say you could have gotten it much cheaper. Where do you stand on this?
Well, on its face, Karen, kaya sinasama din namin sa resolution tungkol sa PSDBM itong issue ng di umanong overpriced laptops. On its face, based on the initial reports, mukhang posible ngang overpriced. So we have to validate that during the Blue Ribbon Committee hearing. Kung hindi man overpriced, we have to look at other issues that have been raised about this particular transaction. At siguradong kailangan naming ungkatin yung dumadaming issue. Hindi natitigil eh. Dumadaming issue tungkol sa PSDBM, how it conducts transactions ostensibly on behalf of government departments, and dapat in the public interest, hindi kontra sa interest ng publiko, di ba, na aabot sa graft and corruption.
Oo. The Commission on Audit in its report is asking the PSDBM to already blacklist certain suppliers. Is there a procedure, Senator? For example, hindi ba dapat you are first accredited before you can even participate in the bidding or before you reach a second level, because the accusation of the COA that SunWest was favored means it did not qualify at all, which is similar to Farmally, your investigation with Farmally. So it means to be a discretionary issue with PSDBM.
Malinaw sa amin nung Farmally investigation, Karen, that Farmally was not qualified at the outset. Napakabagong kumpanya, severely undercapitalized. Hindi ko sigurado if it's the same case for this corporation in the overpriced laptops issue or kung qualified sila. Pero ayon sa sinabi ng COA, pinaboran. Ibig sabihin, there were other companies that in COA's view were more qualified. So yun yung ilan pang mga tanong na dapat or at pwede naming tanungin sa Blue Ribbon Committee investigation, dahil in all these transactions, lalo na nga ngayong panahon ng pandemya where every peso and every resource is all that more precious, dapat sumusunod at hindi lumalabag sa procurement law at lahat pa ng mga batas.
Oo. And ang tanong ko lang before we move on to the CHED releases is yung mga laptop na ito ba, ma'am, have you figured out were they actually all distributed or kumbaga nakatenga lang po ang iba?
Yun yung kailangan din naming i-establish. Were these transactions above board or notorious from start to finish? Were the items overpriced? Were they not even delivered? So to the advantage ba ng gobyerno at ng mamamayan itong transaksyong ito, or in how many cycles was this disadvantageous to government and the people? At tatanungin din namin yon sa lahat pa ng mga transaksyon ng PSDBM na isasama namin sa bago kong resolusyon, so that we can come up with solid recommendations vis-a-vis PSDBM's future transactions, if any, faithfulness to and greater faithfulness to the procurement law, or are there more radical recommendations that Blue Ribbon will come up vis-a-vis PSDBM?
Well, does this mean, Senator, that Christopher Lau will most likely be facing the Senate again? Of course, he was transferred from PSDBM to another agency, but this happened under his leadership.
That's right. So kung basta ang mukhang lumalabas, issue after issue in regarding PSDBM, mukhang lumalabas na yung grupo talaga niya ay lagi't-laging nababanggit. Kung hindi man siya mismo, pero yung mga kagrupo ni dating Yusek Lau. I can't even tell you right now where he is, no? Kasi nag-disappear siya mula sa Farmally investigations. Hindi pa kami tapos noon. Pinaghahanap siya ng PNP sa Cebu, sa Davao, sa iba pang mga probinsya. Hindi na talaga siya nagpakita. So I'm certain that we will be calling him also, I hope, no, on the discretion of the chairperson of the committee, dahil talagang mayat maya, kung hindi man pangalan niya mismo, yung kagrupo talaga niya, yung grupo niya ang nababanggit.
Okay, another one on this is, I believe in the last Congress, resolutions were filed, am I correct, to actually already abolish the PSDBM and another agency where funds are allegedly parked also, right? Two of them, I remember. And where is that now, Senator? Kumbaga, is it even remotely possible that PSDBM will be abolished? Because you do have some supporters saying it's abused, but technically it's meant to make it efficient for government to procure things.
It is meant to do that, and the other agency you referred to, Karen, the Philippine International Trading Corporation or PITC, kahit nung formal investigation, yung PSDBM at pati yung PITC ay talagang mainit ang mata ng Blue Ribbon, lalo na halimbawa ni dating Minority Leader Senator Frank Drilon. Kasi sabi namin, bakit These are supposed to facilitate procurement on the one hand, international trading on the other. But it became their practice, as you mentioned, to park monies of government departments or agencies. Di umano para mas mabilis nga daw na procurement, as you mentioned earlier. But what happened was the monies would be parked there for extended periods of time, accumulating interest. Hindi na ibabalik sa mga home departments or agencies yung interest, hindi na re-revert sa national treasury, and then ginagamit pa sa ganitong mga dubious transactions riddled with graft and corruption. So di ako nagugulat, some of my colleagues in the current 19th Congress have also started airing the possibility that PSDBM in particular would be abolished. So tignan natin how that goes, Karen. Ano yung magiging rekomendasyon ng Blue Ribbon sa PSDBM mismo, sa mga in-house auditors, no, ng mga ahensya at saka departments, and the procurement services within each department themselves. So how should they, or how will they continue working together to come up with, you know, tighter procurements that are advantageous, not disadvantageous to government and the people?
Okay. All right. Now, another issue still related somehow, this is still education, but this is the issue of CHED. You are also calling for an investigation on the allegedly 7 billion pesos that's questionable releases under the CHED Scholarship Agency. Of course, once again, the COA report is asking on how the 7 billion pesos was released. What are your issues with this, with the release of the CHED?
Well, first off, napag-alaman talaga natin, Karen, sa COA report muli, audit findings nila, na halos 7 billion pesos na ipon dito sa mga dubious o kahina-hinalang mga transaksyon. At karamihan nito, ironically, sa ilalim ng Commission on Higher Education para sa UNIFAST, no? Mm-hmm. Yung tinatawag na Unified Student Financial Assistance System, yeah, for tertiary education. Now, for any legislator and during or beyond the budget debates, COA audit reports are like solid gold. They're enough to show that agencies' lapses need to be explained. And mm-hmm. sa katunayan, Karen, na mula nung i-file ko yung resolution na iyan tungkol mm-hmm. sa CHED UNIFAST, wow, ang daming nakikipag-ugnayan sa office ko na hindi daw nila natanggap yung yeah. pera nila. And it's really it'll give you a heartache. Yeah. Many yeah. of these are children of yeah. solo parents. Yes, uh-oh. Karen.
No, I was going to say, and yes. the very name of it is UNIFAST.
Correct, it's not UNISLOW. Yes, it should be yeah. fast. And just to show you how non-fast it is, sabi nung ibang mga estudyanteng ito, huli silang nakatanggap nung kanilang UNIFAST allowance or tuition nung 2019 pa. Yung yeah. iba sa kanila, kalahating semestre lang na halaga ang nakuha. Yung iba, graduating na ngayon,
yeah.
first year pa sila, hindi nakakatanggap. So apat na taon na o limang taon. Marami sa kanila dulog sa CHED over the past years because these COA findings, Karen, covered 2017 to the most recent 2021. But these students only to be told habang dumudulog sila sa CHED na walang budget. Di yan totoo, ha? Uh-huh. At may mga nagre-reklamo na tinatanong pa sila kung natanggap mo na ba yung perang na ipadala. Pero wala naman silang natanggap, uh-oh, isipo. Uh-oh. And they never got it. So ginagawa pa silang tanga.
Sorry to interrupt you. Can you clarify? Problem. So the 7 billion pesos na fund, no, is UNIFAST supposed to go to the student directly or to the university? Because under your resolution, Resolution 128, it states here that 3.4 billion pesos worth yes. of delayed and non-submission billings and documents, it's mm-hmm. to state universities and also local universities and colleges. So saan ba dat napupunta ang perang yon, Senator? Sa universidad, tapos sila ang magdi-distribute sa estudyante?
Pareho, Karen, tama ka. And that's the single biggest item in the almost 7 billion sum, yung 3.4B na iyon. Ang nabibitin naman doon yung mga SUCs at mga local universities and colleges. At ito over 4 years, from 23 years from 2018 to 2021. Yung ibang malalaking items in the magnitude of billions ay dapat diretso sa mga estudyante. We have 1 billion pesos unimplemented and unreverted funds for
meaning
the student
it wasn't
loan
used
program.
It wasn't given to any student.
It wasn't given over 5 years, 2017 to 2021, 1 billion. Malamang pasok dito yung nirereklamo ng mga, nakakalungkot talaga, mga may mga batang may health issues, yung mga magulang nila na wala ng trabaho, lalo na ngayong pandemic. These students are members of families of up to 10 children, mga anak ng mga magsasakat, manging isda, mga anak ng indigent at four-piece families. Yung isa pang billion na item ay 1.003 billion pesos delayed release of financial benefits itong dalawang taon lang, 2020 to 2021. So kung iisipin pa natin, Karen, na maliliit lang, modest lang yung funds per student, ibig sabihin posible napakaraming estudyante ang apektado. At bukod dyan, tulad ng nabanggit mo, a lot of SUCs and local universities and colleges were also affected.
Okay, so one is the delayed releases, which would actually change the life of a student.
Really?
And you also mentioned in your resolution, based on the COA report, although it wasn't a staggering amount, but still big, like 4.43 million in double scholarship grants. So I wanted to ask this, what would a double scholarship grant mean? Like there's one student, she had two scholarships.
Or she would receive twice the amount or two amounts for her scholarship. And matatanong natin, nangyayari ba ang double scholarship? Ang karamihan ng mga reklamo ngayon, hindi nila natanggap yung kanilang tuition at allowance. So what might be involved here is outright fraud in the records that a student was given, in fact, double of her scholarship, but she may only have received one. So saan napunta yung isang halaga? Or both are actually fictitious releases to that supposed scholar.
And you've also cited 200 million pesos worth of unutilized, which means unused allotments for tertiary education subsidy. So what does this mean? 200 million pesos, which could have gone to subsidize, is it the school or is it the student directly, was also unused?
Either, Karen. And whichever way na hindi ito nagamit, ibig sabihin may mga estudyante o may mga tertiary education institutions na may mga scholars na sinusuportahan na nabitin. So these are probably again accounted for by the numerous complaints my office has been receiving every day since I filed the resolution. Na yun na nga, ngayon daw nagkakandarapan na naman siya na maghanap ng pang-advance sa kanyang tuition because his scholarship has been unfunded by CHED UNIFAS the past several semesters or years hanggang ngayon.
Uh-oh. All right. Now, the CHED issued a statement. I'd like to read it to you. Chairman of the Commission on Higher Education, Chairman Prospero de Vera, says, "We take seriously the allegations raised by Senator Risa Ontiveros on the 7 billion questionable releases." He says that they've already answered these observations from the COA 3 to 4 years ago, and CHED has been fully transparent and accountable in the implementation of UNIFAST. He says the beneficiaries of the UAQTE are the beneficiaries mandated by law, and he says no UAQTE funds have been released to students who are not beneficiaries under the law. And he says CHED is ready to meet with you to address your concerns.
Well, I'm glad for that press release of Chairman De Vera. He's willing to meet I'm also willing to meet. I'm glad he takes seriously yung mga laman ng aking resolution at dapat lamang dahil COA findings ito. So lahat kaming nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno, we really have to sit up and take notice kapag COA ang nag-call ng aming attention. And kung nasagot na nila ang mga findings, lalo na adverse findings ng COA 3 to 4 years ago, iche-check namin yon sa Blue Ribbon hearing dahil these findings go all the way up to last year, the newest, the most recent COA findings, COA report of year 2021. At importante kasi kapag may findings ang COA laban sa sino man naming department o ahensya, opisina sa gobyerno, we also have to take cognizance of and implement their recommendations, yung corrective actions moving forward. Para hindi naman hanggang ngayon, Karen, ang dami talagang estudyante pa rin nagre-reklamo, nagdadaing sa opisina ko. They are still in trouble dahil yung inaasahan nilang tulong at suporta mula sa CHED Unifast. Hanggang sa umagang ito ay hindi pa nila natatanggap.
All right. And just to close, during the campaign, the CHED chairman actually publicly endorsed the Unity slate. So he was reappointed by President Marcos Jr. to stay on as CHED. But you do have some sectors in education who were disappointed. I mean, just to be fair, that he was retained as CHED chair. How would you assess his performance overall?
Well, I really feel the evaluations of disappointment or even opposition to the policy positions that he's taken, yung mga actions niya sa ilalim ng CHED Unifa, sa ilalim ng CHED. Pero as with all appointments, yan ay discretion ng appointing authority, yung presidente. Marami naman sa kanila, Karen, ay dadaan sa Commission on Appointments and will have to answer such questions, whether about their track record, yung mga posibleng opposition sa kanila ng mga stakeholders sa panunungkulan ngayong bagong administrasyon. So lahat naman ay magkakaroon ng forum, yung CHED Unifast doon sa Blue Ribbon at ang mga appointments ng appointing authority sa CA.
Okay. All right. Would you have any idea, I'm curious, just how many will be going through the Commission on Appointments this time? I know there are two more lawmakers that have been added to the CA. I remember Senator Aimee Marcos and another one. But how many are you seeing that will have to go through the CA?
Yes, well, a good number. I'll have to get back to you on the exact number so far. Kasi simula ng administrasyon and these first 3 years, the president will be filling up not just his cabinet, but the bureaucracy. So that will be very interesting. Kami naman sa Kongreso, Karen, we will do our duty as far as we can to vet these appointments at siguruhin na totoong the best and the brightest at walang karapatan ay bubuo ng executive.
Uh-oh. Will this affect, is there a possibility that this investigation might affect Prospero de Vera's chances?
Oh, it could. Kung magpang-abot yung investigation dito sa CHED Unifast at yung confirmation hearings, posible. It's always possible dahil ang anumang findings at recommendations tungkol sa isang ahensya or rather tungkol sa isang opisyal ay syempre papasok sa track record nila at that will be open not just for the CA but for the public to examine. Dahil sa huli, kaming lahat na nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno, kahit sila sa executive, we serve, they serve, yes, at the pleasure of the president, but we all serve at the pleasure of the people. At kasama sa people, halimbawa, itong mga estudyante at mga ilang mga magulang nila na nagre-reklamo talaga tungkol dito sa CHED Unifast. And as a solo parent, maraming solo parents ay apektado. I can really feel their suffering and their rightful anger, Karen.
Mm-mm. On that note, Senator Risa Ontiveros, thank you for joining me this morning on these two big issues. Thank you, ma'am. You take care.
You ingat din.